Was there ever any WCW offers to you around the time that your first contract with WWE was before? I think it was 3 years, you said, so there was, I guess, a period of time where you possibly could have jumped?
Not while I was in WWE. Okay. Before I signed with WWE, I already had the Des Moines, Iowa tryout match booked with WWE several weeks in advance. And before I, you know, had the opportunity to perform in front of WWE, I did get the opportunity to perform on the dark match in Nitro in Cincinnati. And so they flew me out of Mexico, WCW did, and I went and did the match. And now Eric says he doesn't remember meeting me, and that may be true. It was back in a time, you know, I had long bleach blonde hair coming out of Mexico at the time, and he had seen so many different talents. Of course, the Val Venis character wasn't even created at that point in time. I was still just known as Sean Morley or Steel from Mexico. In fact, I think I was originally introduced to him as Sean Morley, Steel from Mexico. I believe that's how I was introduced to him. But yeah, we talked a little bit, and then I was basically at the end of that little hoopla of a meeting, I guess. I was told basically, well, I understand you have your meeting with WWE in a few weeks. And the last thing I was told, whatever WWE offers you, at least call us and give us the opportunity to match it. And I never did. I went, when I was offered the WWE contract, I took that contract. And I think a lot of that had to do at the time is I probably would have gone back and forth and negotiated. One thing I noticed was with the WWE locker room, there wasn't really any tension in the locker room. The guys were all really cool. Everybody was getting along. Obviously, you have, you know, your talent, you know, having disagreements and whatever, but that's just normal. When I was in the WCW locker room at the time, it seemed very, very cliquish. It seemed like you could cut the tension with a knife. And I felt very uncomfortable in that business environment. And so just sitting, and I remember Jericho was one of the guys that walked up to me after I had done my dark match. I had been introduced to Bischoff and I had come back to the locker room. Jericho came up to me and he goes, "Don't come here, man, don't come here." And it was one of those things, if WWE makes you that offer, go there. He was one of the guys that, you know, and I never really asked him why he was saying that. I just kind of assumed I could feel what was going on in the locker room. There was cliques, and these cliques weren't just normal little friends cliques. These cliques were, there was a lot of tension between them. At least that's the feeling I got, and it was very uncomfortable. And I compared that to the WWE locker room, and I felt very, very comfortable there. And so that was one of the reasons I did not negotiate back and forth, or at least give WCW the opportunity to match it. I just, you know, I negotiated with WWE only, and we came to a deal, and I took it.
And I highly doubt you would have become as big of a star if you had gone to WCW, because they had very few homegrown stars. And as you said, with all the cliques fighting for positions, a new guy isn't going to have much of a chance.
True. I think going to WCW, I probably would have been lost in the crowd. And during that competitive time, obviously WCW was trying to lock up talent so WWE wouldn't get that talent. And, you know, like I said, I felt a lot more comfortable in the WWE locker room than I did in the WCW locker room. And a lot of that had to do with the cliques that were all jockeying for position. And again, that goes back to having so many different heads in a company pulling the company in different directions, and it takes away from what really should be a clear-cut vision for the company. If you don't have a clear-cut vision for the company, there's nothing for the fans to grab onto. You got some fans that'll grab onto this vision, you got some fans that'll grab onto that vision, you got some fans that'll grab onto this vision, and everybody just gets torn apart. And so the one thing I saw with WWE was you had Vince McMahon's vision, and you had all the talent, all the producers, and all the employees getting in behind Vince to help him develop that vision. The fans understood that vision because there's only one vision. They recognized that vision, they understood it, and they loved it. And that's what I think makes a company really gel with the fans. When the fans understand what the vision is, they agree with the vision, they enjoy that vision, it's not confusing to them, and it sells tickets. They're more than willing to give the money for those tickets to enjoy that vision. But when you have a company that's got 4, 5, 6 different visions, fans don't know what to grab onto. And I think that's a big downfall for professional wrestling companies.